Oh, is that a wart on your finger?
Yeah, I got it from a pet frog.
Actually, this is a clear case of Verruca vulgaris.
What?
Actually, warts are the manifestations of infectious disease.
But how did I catch this?
You were exposed to a pathogen, in this case, a virus. However, a pathogen is anything that can cause disease, and there are numerous categories, including protozoa, bacteria, fungi, prions, and of course, viruses. Although all can make you sick, human illness is usually caused by either a virus or a bacteria. However, most bacteria operate in a symbiotic relationship within your body, causing no signs or symptoms whatsoever. In fact, you have 10 times as many bacterial cells in your body as you do your own. And without bacteria, you would not even be able to survive.
But I thought you said this was a viral infection.
Indeed, it is. All viral infections are caused by a virus, which is a small amount of RNA or DNA, aka instructions for cellular structure and function. When a virus infects a human cell, its structure and function will change. When your cells don't function normally, this is called disease.
So, how did a virus get onto my finger anyway?
Well, modes of transmission are often the same, even though the manner in which pathogens make a person sick are different. Diseases don't just magically appear in or on your body. There must be a point of entry for the pathogen. There are two types of transmission: contact and non-contact. Contact can be direct or indirect. Non-contact can be vehicle, vector, or airborne. Contact transmission is when one person infects another, either through direct physical contact, infected skin, blood, saliva, or other bodily fluids, while indirect transmission is when an individual touches a surface where an infectious disease was deposited by an infected individual. These objects or surfaces are referred to as fomites.
For real?
Fomites, for real. When an individual coughs or sneezes and droplets become airborne, they can also cause an infection.
So, you're saying I got this wart because somebody sneezed on me?
No! More often than not, we get an infection simply by touching a surface. Someone who had a wart probably touched a doorknob or a keyboard, and then you came along and touched the same surface, thus getting the virus on your skin, where it caused individual cells to start looking different and ultimately functioning differently than the cells around them. The same principle is true for most infections. We get the pathogen on our hands, and then we do something stupid, like rub our eyes, pick our nose, eat a French fry.
So, how do I keep from getting sick anyway?
There are multiple strategies for preventing infectious disease transmission, but the two most important are staying current on your immunizations and washing your hands. Can I pet your frog?
Yeah, just don't touch my wart.
Oh, okay. Hi.